home. It's the place where you can rest your head at night, get ready for a new day, and make some of your fondest memories. And some not so fond memories, like when your old furnace starts making that awful rattling sound. Or when you can't handle another summer with just a box fan and decide you need air conditioning. In the first episode in this series, we talked about heat pumps, one system that can both heat and cool a building. They use electricity to move heat either into your home or out of it, depending on the temperature outside. And they do that really efficiently. Last time, we gave you an overview of heat pumps and how their efficiency can be great for your wallet and the environment. But now, let's really jump in and see how these things work. Hi, I'm Alexis Dahl, a science journalist in Michigan's Upper Peninsula, and this is a deep dive on heat pumps. Today, there are several types of heat pumps. Some connect to ducts, others are ductless, some extract heat from the air, and others pull heat from the ground or water. For the sake of this example, let's say you're using an air source heat pump to warm your home on a chilly February day. Heat pumps are a slow, steady source of heat and work best when you set them and forget them. Here's how they work. When you turn up your thermostat, the refrigerant in your heat pump gets moving. Refrigerant is a fluid that can turn from a liquid to a gas and back again in order to carry and release heat. You can also find it in fridges, freezers, and vehicles. And you can think of it like heat's delivery driver. Refrigerant can collect heat from one spot, then drop it off somewhere else. Different heat pumps have different kinds of refrigerant, with names like R32 or R454, and experts are always working on new ones that work more efficiently and are better and better for the environment. But here's the big thing to know. When it's in a liquid state inside your heat pump, the refrigerant is really cold. For most, we're talking less than minus 15 degrees Fahrenheit. And this makes it great at moving heat. Last episode, we mentioned that according to the laws of physics, heat naturally moves from warmer spots to colder ones. It's like when your warm hand melts a falling snowflake. The heat from your palm moves into the snow, turning it into water. But why is that? If you zoom way in, what we vaguely think of as heat is just the movement of molecules. The faster something's molecules vibrate, the more energy they have, and the hotter that thing is. On the flip side, if something's molecules vibrate more slowly, that object is colder. Well, when two molecules collide, like one from a snowflake and one from your hand, some of that energy gets transferred from the faster vibrating molecule to the slower one. So your warm hand ends up a little cooler, and that icy snowflake ends up a little warmer. Heat pumps really take advantage of this law of physics. At the beginning of the heat pump cycle, the liquid refrigerant flows through the outdoor coil, which is made of copper or aluminum. And since the refrigerant inside the coil is often less than minus 15 degrees, that coil is colder than the outside air in all but the chilliest environments. That means that when the air molecules and coil molecules collide, heat energy is going to transfer from the warmer air into the cold coil and then into the refrigerant. And to speed up this process, the fan in the outdoor unit pulls air across the coils. Ultimately, this warms up the liquid refrigerant until it reaches minus 15 Fahrenheit. Then it starts to boil, turning from a liquid into a gas. But you're still not going to be able to heat up your house with gas that cold. So now the refrigerant travels into the system's compressor, which uses a motor to squeeze the gas into a smaller space. There are different types of compressors, but ultimately they all make the gas molecules move faster. You can imagine this like a game of ping pong. If you and your opponent are standing far apart, the ball bounces slowly back and forth. But as you move in closer, things get intense. Every time the ball hits your paddle, it goes a little faster. That's basically what the compressor does to the molecules of the refrigerant. And like we mentioned, when something's molecules move faster, that means it gets hotter. In this case, the compressed refrigerant quickly gets above 100 degrees Fahrenheit. At this point, our refrigerant is at its hottest, and it's ready to leave the compressor and arrive at the indoor coils, which, like the outdoor ones, are also copper or aluminum. And that rule of heat transfer from earlier applies here, too. The refrigerant coil is now warmer than the air in the room around it, so heat energy gets transferred to the colder space. A fan in the indoor unit then pushes that heat into your home. As the refrigerant drops off its heat, it cools down and eventually falls below minus 15 Fahrenheit. When it does, it condenses back into a liquid and it heads to its last stop, the expansion valve. This is the opposite of the compressor stage. Here, the molecules get more space to move around instead of less. The ping pong players move farther apart and the ball bounces more slowly between hits. This helps the refrigerant cool down even more until it's right back where it started, ready to bring more heat into your home. And this process repeats until your house is however warm you want it to be. Now, like we mentioned earlier, heat pumps can also act as air conditioners. By reversing the refrigeration cycle, they can move heat out of your home and into the great outdoors. Here, the roles of the indoor and outdoor coils are switched. For cooling mode, a reversing valve near the compressor changes the direction the refrigerant is flowing. The fan in the indoor unit pulls the warm air inside your home over the cold refrigerant coils. The refrigerant boils into a gas and your house cools down. Finally, the refrigerant travels to the outdoor coils and releases its heat into the outdoor air. And voila, your heat pump becomes your home's air conditioner too. By taking advantage of a basic law of physics, heat pumps are one system that can keep your home the perfect temperature all year. But they're not just used for climate control. We'll see you again for episode 3 and talk more about how this technology is being used to make other major appliances in your home more efficient than ever. See you then. This educational heat pump video is brought to you by the Upper Peninsula Power Company's Energy Efficiency Program.